Welcome to another lecture of Pharmaceutical Jurisprudence. In our last lecture, we finished with Unit 1 and today we'll be starting with our second unit. And the first topic in second unit is studying about different drug schedules. As we've already discussed earlier, what schedules exactly are? Schedules are basically categorization of different categories of drugs, cosmetics and biological products. We basically categorize them and we study them under different schedules. Right? I have already attached a document with your lecture regarding the different drug schedules and details have been given in that particular document. I hope you have all gone through that particular document. So today we'll be studying two categories, two schedules of drugs, that is Schedule H and Schedule G. Right? So let's start. So firstly, we'll be studying Schedule G drugs. So Schedule G mainly contains hormonal preparations like cisplatin, bleomycin, primidone, hydroxyurea. Okay, so the drug products which are included in Schedule G should have a label mentioning caution, statement of caution that this particular drug product is dangerous for consumption except under expert medical supervision. Right? So this particular caution statement should be mentioned in the label of the drugs which belong to the Schedule G. And the drugs which belong to this particular category of drugs, it should be the caution statement should be written with black color within a box of red color and nothing else should be included in that particular box. Only the caution should be mentioned in that particular red box, right? And next, it is very important to maintain the record of sales of all the drugs which are mentioned in Schedule G, and that particular record of purchase as well as the record of the sale of that particular drug should be kept for a period of 2 years, and that particular register should be available at the time of inspection. Now the next category of drug that we need to study is Schedule H drugs. So we'll start with Schedule H drugs. While dispensing the drug, the pharmacist or the person who is selling the drug should keep in mind, he should take care of what date and time has been mentioned on the prescription. He should not dispense Schedule H drugs for a backdated or for a prescription which is very old, right? Then the drugs which are categorized in Schedule H, they should have a label with a sign of RX, and the label should clearly state that it is a Schedule H drugs. Then a warning has to be mentioned stating that this particular drug product should be sold by retail on the prescription of a registered medical practitioner only. And initially there were 510 drugs which were there in Schedule H category, but presently after the revision of Drug Technical Advisory Board, there are 536 Schedule H drugs in India. Now this is one of the example of the label. Firstly, you have to keep in mind that RX is written on the top. As you can see in the topmost side, left hand side, RX is written. Then there is a red color box stating that this particular drug belongs to category H, and there is a warning that this is to be sold only after when a person produces a prescription from a registered medical practitioner only, right? And one more very important point, you can all see a red color line in this particular label. So a red color line means that this particular drug is not over-the-counter drugs. They do not belong to the category of over-the-counter drugs, and this particular drug can be sold only if a customer produces a prescription, right? Then there is an additional category of drug, that is Schedule H1. This particular schedule is very recently made. It was made in 2013 and mainly it contains antibiotics. This particular category was mainly made to restrict the selling of antibiotics. Schedule H1 drugs are mainly third and fourth generation antibiotics. Some antitubercular drugs are also included, and there are certain habit forming drugs which are included in this particular category. right? Examples of this particular drugs are stated here, right? Ciprofloxacin, clindamycin. Now, there are two very important criteria which you should keep in mind if you have to dispense the drugs which belong to the category of Schedule H1. Right. So the first thing is that the drug which is dispensed under this particular category, it should be recorded in a separate register. In the register, you should mention the name and address of the prescriber, the person who has written the prescription. You should mention the name of the patient and the name of the drug which you are dispensing, along with the quantity of that particular drug which is given to the customer. Right. And the register has to be maintained properly, and it has to be produced at the time when you have an inspection in your shop and when a drug inspector asks you to give you the details of sale. And the record should be kept safely for a period of 3 years. Then there is an important criteria that you should keep in mind, that Schedule H1 drugs, they should be labeled with the symbol RX, and that particular RX should be written with a red color, right? It should be red in color, and the label should bear the following words in a box, right? With a red border, and the word should be that this particular drug product is dangerous to take except in accordance with medical advice, and this is not to be sold by retail without the prescription of a registered medical practitioner. Like, this is an example of Schedule H1 category of drug. You can see that RX is mentioned with red color, and there is a red color box stating that this particular drug belongs to the category of H1 drugs, and it is mentioned that this particular drug is dangerous to consume without the advice of a medical practitioner, and secondly, that you cannot sell this particular drug product without a prescription from a registered medical practitioner. Okay, so thank you so much, students. This was all for today's lecture. I hope you understood the lecture well. If you have any queries, any doubt, you can always reach out to me. You can WhatsApp me, you can drop me a message, you can call me at any point of time. And thank you so much for giving your time.